Nope, it's Rise. Okay. He's not running exhaust, thankfully. I'm a little concerned about that. Yeah, I could run cleanse, but I'm gonna lose kill power on him in lane if I do. Basically, if you're playing Syndra and you know the enemy, or anyone who's burst, per se, if you're playing a burst and you know the enemy is gonna be running exhaust, it can be worth your time to run cleanse. Just so you don't lose your burst combo. Okay, if I shut off Minecraft while I'm in the game, my CPU usage is just fine, actually. That sounds good to me. Welcome to Siren Control. So, the question becomes, is it a flask rise? Let's crank for Rek'Sai Tremor Sense. I am not walking over there. Does she really have the Jaws theme? Are you serious?
Easily.
Wow.
30 seconds until minions spawn.
She actually plays the Jaws theme when she is submerged. Flask Rise? No. Crystal Rise? No Emrise either. Ooh, interesting. Makes him quite killable, actually. Why is he doing that?
Minions have spawned.
Okay, what's your deal, buddy?
My potential is limitless.
Hits two and runs at me for splash. Yeah, he throws the bouncing ball basically and he tries to capitalize on a bunch of damage when you're in your minion wave. Walk out your minions and you're fine. Stun means free auto attack, back off.
People fear what they cannot.
Now mind you, I just took like 70 damage from creeps doing that. So that was not actually too much of a positive trade for me. Why do they always come when I don't have stuns?
By force of will.
So both the spots are gone. I can very easily bully him, but I can't really kill him. Miss. So he goes in for doubles, eh? Interesting. So what are you gonna snowball off of that? Rush Emrys or Catalyst? Hello, Mancena. Yeah, basically, Rek'Sai's unique mechanic, Tremor Sense, and to an extent her tunnels, the utility value of them is just too good. You can't really nerf the numbers on them. Tremor Sense, you would have to functionally reduce into uselessness, or turn into like a toggled ability where she loses damage, or something. Tear into Catalyst, so... pretty high death water physics. Chasing quite far there, buddy. Like, man, where's Rek'Sai coming from? Oh, she's not here. Interesting. So he is going to hit 6 before me. He's got 2 kills on me, basically. Alright, he doesn't have Catalyst, he doesn't have Negatron. Stay away from his snare, because that's all he's fishing for right now, is snaring me. They are nothing to me. I don't have flash, not for 2 minutes. I want to try killing him, but I know the second we start fighting, he's going to pop his passive shield, and it's going to be a lot harder for me. Oh, knew it. Rek'Sai. But I probably should have noticed the stun rise, it would have gotten me out a little bit better. Now the issue becomes, he goes back, he gets his Catalyst. That's going to be a bit harder to work on him. Dun-dun-dun, null magic mantle, basically the equivalent of chalice. Okay, that's fine. More. I can be so much more. Ow. You cannot range rise, for what it's worth. Knock it off. Now the speed bonus from his ultimate and boots makes it a little tricky though. Speed actually kind of matters against him. Magic shield does nothing against tower shots. My potential is limitless. An enemy has been slain. So basically he has to poke me with his skill shot Q, which you can dodge and set my increase with. Or chain root me and do a bunch of splash damage to mini wave. Your team has destroyed a turret. People fear. So he has to kind of force the issue. And until he gets a lot of items, he has trouble doing that. really fast with his ult.
Let them try to stop me.
I got about like a minute on my ward still, so. Blitzcrank lurking around, so I'm not gonna go near the bottom side. Yep, there he is.
I can be so much more.
How did he get that? Eh. Second blue for me. Shove the Zen while he's dead, so he loses stuff to the tower. I'm gonna go back and pick up Chalice while I still can. And probably I'm going to run straight into Sorkboot to the Lacquery, so I have something of a movement speed comparison with this guy. But he's still going to be like 50-60 faster when he pops his ult. But if you force him to pop his ult, stun him, and walk away, he's down his ult, and you're just down your stun.
I am in control.
Now if he flashes and he sticks to you, then it's a bit of an issue. But he's using flash at that point. Size nearby. Let's be dangerous and stick out our neck. Hey. Yep, there's Roz. I'm like, man, where is he? Ah, he's janking from behind. How about that?
A whole world to toy with.
He was really debating if he wanted to flash over the wall for me, too. That might be Heisendong. It's not his original name, so I'm not sure if it's a smurf he renamed or someone who's imitating him. But I don't keep track on that, so. Yes, yes, I'm coming.
An ally. People fear when they cannot understand. My potential is limitless. An enemy has
down bottom. Now they're basically done. Ooh, hi there, Pink Ward. Now in middle, you say? Unless Ryze is waiting in the top brush to try and grab me, so I'm gonna hold on to my E for a second here. You're not sure where the enemy is, and you're kind of sticking your neck out, hold on to your E. Don't wave clear of it. Even if it is your second max ability. Because if you don't have it and they see you use it for wave clearing, they're going to run in on you.
This power is mine to command.
I didn't get it. force of will. He's got his Murktra. Steinheim's gonna be a bit of a pain now. Blitzcrank, kind of shadowing near the bottom there. Took one. Three middle. Heimer's pushing in top, so really someone, one or two people are going to be stuck there dealing with him. Yeah, we can be pushing middle or bottom. Tech's so good. Holy jeez, that was close. Into death cap we go then. Melted. Or the wall. Enemy triple kill. No good. My potential is limitless. Oh boy, no. Three just died around dragon, and they're gonna get that one. Plus the kill, so that's effectively three kills plus dragon. I go there, I'm gonna die, so. Already gone. Like that. People fear what they cannot understand.
I am in control.
Against AD mids, I will go tier into seekers, depending on which kind of mid it is. I don't like Morellos on Syndra in general, so I have a special tier bit page where it's scaling CDR and tier, so I have my CDR taken care of and tier gives me more mana, so. And down bot. Area's warded, nothing's gonna happen down there. Easily. Pick run, okay. Grab a blue buff for the siege here. Rises bottom. Kinda not getting any help to push though.
Let them try to stop.
Ryze is gonna flank around from the side. Oh, the auto attack! Auto attack got me. God dang it. I was like, yes, I can slow them, I can stun them, I'll get away with the slow rage and auto attack. Story of my life. Yeah, a bunch of emeralds. Well, at least I'm going into void staff next. Rest in peace.
A whole world to toy with.
He ults away. What? I mean, yeah. He wants to live. I guess that works. Nation picks up metal.
This power is mine to command.
Fresh hooks always throw me off a little bit because I'm not adjusting to them like I should be. That's costing me kills and damage. And cooldowns. Because the first tug of his chain is always further than his second. It always throws me off a little bit. That, go back. Oh, he got an alacrity upgrade. Nice. Two.
By force of will.
Since I'm getting blue buff fairly consistently, I'm just gonna go straight to void staff so I can actually eat through all this tankiness they got going on. And then I'll pick up the fiends afterwards. Surprise, where are you? I want to see your movement speed. There you are, 422. Ooh, he's actually 20 units faster than me. Without his ultimate. Okay, good to know. So he can outspeed me without using his ult. Size pushing top, so there's three metal. Save my ult for something that's actually dangerous. Ah, I see. When she's activating Tremor Sense, you'll actually hear the music. Curious. You can teleport direct side tunnels. Ain't that something? Yeah, not worth flashing. This guy. Pick up our void staff. Bottom.
I can be so much more. By force of will.
Flash. Yeah, but now they're all here. Neat. Oh, one's dead.
Imprisoned.
The knockup still had me. I should have just flashed when I stunned him and comboed and killed him. That would have been a much better play. Also, I should have just flashed Malphite too. That would have been a better play. So, slow reactions, not doing what I should have done, cost us that whole fight. Hello, Neatrix. Yep, I stream Cinder a lot. And if you have any particular questions about her, let me know. Something like 1200 games now, something stupid like that, apparently. Zerat's interesting because you can kind of fish for engagement windows on Zerath in laning phase, and kind of in teamfights too. The problem you run into is that if Zerath really wants to be, I don't want to fight you, he can. Because he has one of the longest ranges, one of the longest consistent ranges in the game. It's my stun. Why your squish? Jump. So in laning phase, you can fish for your stun to kind of pick him up a little bit. Team fights, you have to force the situation on his team. Make him go in places he doesn't want to be in, make him behave very awkwardly. If someone can initiate for you and you follow up, that's usually the best. Because if you're going all out of your way to initiate, you don't have any personal defense. Because you do one or the other, never both.
My potential is limitless.
Where is this bottom? We're just sitting around being sieged in middle. Doesn't do us any good. Yes, yeah, so now Ryze is with their team, so we don't get anything for trying to force those. There you go. Damage, starts his taunt, flash his way. Nah. That flash though isn't gonna get us anything, so it might have been not have been the best use of my flash. Yeah, get my 40% CDR, run back down. Ludens on Syndra is not good for her damage combo or her burst pattern. There are better choices in terms of raw damage. If you like Ludens for the movement speed, which is basically what it does now, you can get a fair bit of mileage out of that. And the new AP itemization that's coming, there might be a viable build in the form of like Luden's Rylai's for heavy ranged Kite Syndra, which would be a distinct playstyle at that point. But in current patch, if you want to do damage, there's better choices for her. Let's run top and pick a free CS while we wait.
By force of will.
Syndra E has two components, knockback, dark spheres, and the pulse waves. The pulse waves and the dark spheres share their damage. If one hits, the other will not do damage. So in this understanding, if you snipe someone with an E, it does damage. If someone is in the middle of scatter and they get hit by both a sphere and E, they will... Jesus Christ. That's a lot of damage. Now, one or the other. So if you overlap and do both, it won't double dip damage. It doesn't have MRS, so I can actually burn through them if I have all my spheres up correctly. Don't go that way.
A whole world to toy with. Your turret has been destroyed.
Third dragon. Full build depends on the kind of game. I'll get into that in a minute here. Some stuns all day. Full build, typical AP carry build, is something like Athene's, Woda, Deathcap, Voidstaff, Boots, and Zhonya's. If you want to do like a versus AD build, you're going to have Tyr in place of Athene's. And you're going to have scaling armor yellows and scaling CDR blues. Which is basically the two main builds I run right now. So at this point, we're running out of Baron. Dragon Baron down, so whoever catches who, essentially in this next minute or so.
try to stop me.
There's Blitz. Missile though. Sign with Banshee's Veil. This whole area is warded, so I know exactly what we're doing. Split.
My potential is limitless.
Hey, there we go. What's up? Now let's run the middle and start pushing that in. Rise will be up, my ult will be up, I have none of my sons, neither does he, I believe. Grab you. On a magical journey. After. Always clear Rakshai tunnels whenever you can. Ignoring them gives her a license to do whatever she wants. Back.
By force of will.
Will the Ancients on Syndra benefits a kind of ranged control style where you sit back and you're very, very careful at positioning, because any poke you take, you can shrug off given enough time. So Siege poke matchups it does the best in. Heavy bursts, assassins that kind of run in really quick are a bit of an issue, but the single target heal from her ultimate can range in the hundreds of HP depending on which phase of the game we're talking about. So you can rip a lot out of that, in addition to all your other defensive measures like armor, Seraph shield, Zhonya's, etc. She will heal during Zhonya's, which is a very useful example. So, it's pretty good for what it does. If you want to get, like, even more damage, you could just trade out for, like, I don't know, Lutens or something. But that's gonna change in the next patch, where it's gonna be kind of normalized. Our Thresh being DC'd there kind of sucked. Mission of the Scimitar. Ah, that's Force Dragon for free.
More. I can be so much more. I am in control.
Quite possibly even Baron. Nah, almost definitely it's Baron. Yep, that's Baron. So we're down one, they got Baron and Force Dragon. Yeah, this is looking pretty done. Good lord, that stings. Rough day. No, I do not smurf. So, what you see here is my only account. Oh, there's the Rise Flash. Silver movement speed bonus. Not enough, though. Yeah, having Zonja there would have been really useful. That's for me, so. Hello, Malphie. First match of the day. Kinda topsy-turvy. Lots of throws.
My potential is limitless.
Yeah, the issue becomes I can focus on Lucian, but all the defensive summoners are going to be thrown onto him, and then Ryze is free to do whatever he wants. Yeah, Alexander's base the most, followed by Justicar. I don't care for the other two.
People fear what they cannot understand.
What can we do here?
Force of
will. So now the fishing game begins. We're all basically full items. Whoever makes the better play in these team fights is gonna win.
I am in control.
One fights bottom, he probably has TP. Seven spheres for Lucian, you say? Okay. Ooh, didn't flash in time. Zipper! Oh god, she ran into them! Heimer turret. The Heimer turret! Oh no! Good lord, Rex size burrow heal. I got 20 seconds. Might be able to turn the inhibitor. I saw a Malphite angling for me, and I was just like, I got a flash out of this. Didn't flash. Now I'm dead. They recovered from that fight pretty well, though, all things considered. Yeah, I'm costing this game pretty hard.
More. I can be so much more.
She's gonna get fifth dragon, most likely. Not coming to clear, you say. So, they all have fifth dragon.
I am in control.
Heimerdinger's a god. Ooh, that missed by a mile. That Heimer ult grenade, though, just got us Baron. Yeah, the issue is if I try to keep seven spheres up ready at all times like that, my mana is going to run out even with blue Athenes, or blue pot Athenes. It's gonna be hard to coordinate. Cause I only have a half second window to do a 7-seer flat. Seven seer ultimate. Dun dun dun. Arxai with the guardian angel. I blue buff and blue pot, so. these spheres stacking. Get them out of the fight. Hope that's all they needed. You'll notice the Lucian shield and the heals all dumped down on him, so that Seven Seers would have killed him on its own, it's just he had a lot of defensive stuff dropped on him. But still, we won, mostly won the fight with that. But Sloppy, I can describe that better. Absolutely, a game like this, you could probably sell it, but I mean, at the end of the day, your only option is Ludens. Rylai's is no good right now. Tier requires stacking, which you're not going to get done in the next minute or so. Yeah, I could have played that 7 sphere a lot better. I think it was actually a 6 sphere. I didn't do 7. Good catch. Also good catch, it's probably game. Not trying to end, okay. I mean, we could have ended there, but okay. Rek'Sai's dead. Seven Seers Volution, you say? Let's try that again. I don't have my flash. Hi, I'm out of mana. So super out of mana. Now I have mana. Just need one kill, please. Heal up in a heartbeat, but okay. Ooh. Got my blue, I still have time. So I can force Lucian away from the fight with my ultimate, because he has to see how much damage he's taking before he can commit, because anyone else will pick him off in the meantime. But unfortunately, I'm not getting kill off that, which is the most important part. I really love the yellow upgrade for mini side stones. It's really useful, especially in situations like this where I can't buy wards anymore.
My potential is limitless. This inhibitor is respawning soon.
Too slow. No thanks.
A whole world to toy with.
Get back up again. 15 seconds for my ultimate. Goodbye. You don't have Zhonya's, I don't care what you got. What a match. Good lord. I had some awful plays. I was just missing way too many of my stuns that really mattered in those fights. Alright, I'm gonna get some water and we'll keep going, so I'll be back.